Hello, everybody, and welcome. So let me get everything set up here. We got Discord going, so if you guys want to check out the stream and hang out, you can hop in our Discord. The link should be below on Facebook and in YouTube. So come on by and hang out. We got a few people here, it looks like. Otherwise, chat to me in the stream chats that we got going on. I should have them all up here now, I believe. What's up, Hank? Yeah, Phanteks for the win. So that's what tonight's all about. It was very awesome of Brian at Phanteks to hook us up with an Enthu Pro M to mod on the stream. Let me switch the camera so you can actually see this instead of just the top. There you go. So, maybe. There we go. Okay, so we got it still all boxed up here just because I kind of wanted to wait and do this with all of you guys. So this should be sort of fun because once we get this all unboxed, we can kind of talk about all the different plans we have for this. I've already got some ideas brainstormed, but I'd love to hear what you guys have to say as well. So we might as well get to it. We'll also be giving away a Phanteks Halo fan frame for all of you lovely folks that are watching. And well, it'll just be for one of you that answers the question correctly. But we'll do that in a bit here. Also, until Thursday, through Thursday, it's 10% off all of our DIY modding tools. So there's the code in the description below of the video for that as well. So you can check that out, get some tools. I could show you some of the, I believe I have some of the tools that are in the DIY modding tools section of our site. At least I should. Oops. Restream chat. Where'd you go? There we go. Oh, cool. It's in two boxes. Glorious. It's a double unboxing video. This is gonna be fun. Maybe not. It's not gonna come out. Well, Phanteks gets an A plus for packaging, apparently. I don't think my Evolve came in two boxes, but oh well. So this ain't happening. Oh. Maybe, just maybe. Okay, so we're getting there. Maybe. I have no idea how to get this beast out all on my own. Maybe if I do it on the floor and lift up. Box in a box. What's up, man? Dude, the box is stuck. Oh, I see why it's stuck. It's a handle in a handle. I think that's what happened there. Okey-doke. So, yeah, this is like my third Phanteks case, I think, that I've ever worked in. So it should be a lot of fun. I used to use the Evolve for my case. I've done a build in the P300 or the P400, I think, but never the Pro M. It's a little bit older case, although this is the tempered glass version, so it's like the newer one, I guess. These damn handles. So this should be an interesting case to work with. And you guys will definitely have to let me know what kind of mods you want to see with it. I saw something about a vertical GPU mount already. Hank's got like a infinity mirror idea for it. So both ideas I think we can probably play with. Almost there. Okay. Sheesh. Another box. Woo! We got a box. Poke a hole on top suction. Yeah, it was actually the handles that were keeping it, but I guess the suction doesn't help either. But we're past that part now. Told we should flip it back over. Now we should be able to get to the case. That's actually kind of nice that they ship it in two boxes, because most places don't like put it in a box for shipping when they ship the case itself. So it's definitely a good idea. I like to see that. So let's see how we can get this out without breaking it. What's up, Mr. Death Size? There's another box, yeah. Don't. We're gonna pull this plate in. Somebody finally in Discord. I can hear.
What do you mean? I've been here the whole time.
Yeah, but she didn't say anything.
I said hi before you went live.
Yeah, I mute the Discord before I go live. Come on. I wish I could watch today's stream. My AP physics test started half an hour late. Oh no. That sucks, man. I hope the test was fun, though. Now we're getting somewhere. Who knew unboxing could be so much fun? I honestly don't do that many unboxing like videos or anything like that with all the crap I get. Do you guys like to see unboxing? Like I could honestly, probably most times I could save up like my packages for the week that I get from PBCs and whatnot, and then do a little unboxing stream every week of some sort.
Yeah.
Just show you guys.
Make it a separate stream though, like a different day.
Like a different day. Yeah, I suppose it just kind of depends on what days I get stuff. I actually got this last Friday. The case, at least. So, she looks good. I hope you guys have been brainstorming some mod ideas, because this case should be a lot of fun to work with, to be honest. I'm pretty excited. It's tempered glass. I think I will be sending the glass panel back to PPCs so Jeremy can etch it, because we can actually do tempered glass etching. It's just really expensive. But I could still get you guys an example. It's not too bad, like if you just want like a little logo like in the corner or something like that. Which is something that I'd honestly rather have anyways than like a big thing across the whole tempered glass panel. So, yeah, it looks like the same interior as the Evolve. Awesome. But that's good, actually. It's very familiar. We do have this 5 1/4 bay, though, which is actually where Hank was talking about doing like an infinity mirror in the 5 1/4 bay. Which would be interesting, so I can work on something like that. Otherwise, we can definitely make a new PSU shop for this bad boy. We can rip this sucker out. I've done that before. I think I've got like one of these PSU shrouds in my scrap bin. Maybe another custom res. I don't know. It's up to you guys. We can definitely do some vertical GPU stuff. I know CableMod should have theirs soon, so if anything, we can demo that. I'm going to have this magnetic LCD mod pretty soon, which it might actually fit right here nicely in this case, or else right here. So I'll be showing that off to you guys pretty soon, as soon as I get in another monitor at least. Double pump setup. Ooh. Like, you would want a dual loop in this case or something? Is that something that you'd want to see? Because that would definitely be a challenge. This isn't a massive case by any means. It's pretty normal sized.
Challenge. Yeah. Think you'd almost have to take like the MMRS divided by two.
That is a good idea, though, to use that, the dual MMRS. Yeah, we could work on that, though. Or I could make a custom res that's a dual res. The options are kind of endless with what we can do. Like I said, I was planning on doing some kind of infinity mirror mod that Hank wants to see. Oh, no, the magnet is coming off the fan filter.
You could do one res that actually feed both loops.
That's impossible. Unless you divide, it still has to have two chambers. No matter what.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, that's what I'd make, is one res that has two chambers. So,
obviously. Either that, or you split it so that the water mixes together, but you'd have to use the same coolant on both sides.
Yeah, but then it'd still be a single loop, just with two pumps.
That's true.
So yeah, I could see about getting a dual loop in here, somehow or another. I wonder if you can still fit a 360 in here, even if you still have this front or this 5 1/4 bay. It isn't tiny. It might be able to fit.
That's Eclipse, right?
What's that?
A Phanteks Eclipse?
No, this is a Pro M.
Oh.
Yeah, they all, honestly, the interior looks exactly the same for all of them. Like I said, I had the Evolve looks exactly like this. Besides the 5 1/4 bay, I've worked in a PE300. I did a build in one for a friend. Looks the same, except
for the Pro M is shorter in the back.
I thought it'd be smaller than this, but it's a pretty much a normal ATX case.
Yeah, it's just a shorter Lux.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The Lux is a pretty big case, to be honest. I really kind of like this front grill, though. Like, I do almost want to mod it. But maybe I just do something that just goes over top of this. Because this is honestly a great intake. Like, this feels like metal, as far as I can tell. It's a metal grill.
Yeah, that's a metal mesh with, like, a plastic nylon behind it.
Yeah. Let me take off the front panel. This is actually a really nice front panel design. I like it. Besides the 5 1/4 bay, but with the insert, you don't even see it. How do you take off the front panel? I really don't want to break it yet.
You pull from the bottom.
That's what I'm doing.
You gotta make sure the bottom filter's off.
The bottom filter's off?
Okay, yeah, there should be a sliding filter on the bottom. If it's gone, then you just pull the front panel off from the bottom.
Oh, jeez. She's on there tight. Okay.
Yep.
Oh, and we got our hardware in the back here. Can take off the back panel. But, yeah, you can definitely fit a 280. They put two 140 fans in here. Great, more stock Phanteks fans. Can't wait. They're actually pretty good. I just never use them.
Yeah,
really. I just good. Never use them for anything.
I just ordered their RGB fan things. Not the actual fans.
Yeah, the halos.
Yeah, the halos.
Yeah, so we'll be giving away one of their digital ones tonight. Suppose I could do that trivia question pretty soon.
Well, I just ordered 10 of the regular halos.
The regular halos? Well, I guess we could give out whatever halos version you want, but they're all like the same. Besides the metal ones. I think there's only two of the plastic ones. So we got our accessory box. It comes out of here. Why is it stuck?
Hey, Matt, what case is this?
This is the Pro-M.
Pro-M.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I got the Intulux, the non-tempered glass version.
Okay. Yeah, I used the P400 in a build, and I've used the Evolve for my own personal build. Should I do the trivia about one of those two builds?
Considering I have no clue what the hell you're talking about.
Yeah, same here.
See, I figured you guys wouldn't know. I made sure that, like, Blaze Mods disappeared after I started with PPCs, so no one knows about my previous building experiences. So I don't know. This looks like we can probably have a lot of fun with this case. It should be, at least. Like I said, we can probably get rid of this shroud. Oh, of course they riveted still, so that's good. We'll have to drill those out.
Yeah, that's one thing I didn't like about the Phanteks, all the rivets.
Yeah, they do use all rivets, but honestly, like, this is a great shroud for a stock shroud. It's got, like, the removable part for your radiator and fans. However, if, like, you put a pump res on the front... Shroud. Yeah, it's a full shroud, which is nice. It's just... I'm pretty sure
the Pro is the same shroud as the Lux.
Yeah, the P300 is the same shroud as this, and same with the Evolve, it's the same shroud. Like I said, I have a red one from the P300 that I built in my scrap bin. It looks exactly the same as this.
No, I mean the Lux and the Pro standard have a detachable shroud.
Oh, yeah. That's true. Let me change some settings here really quick. But what other mod? You guys maybe want to see a dual loop. That's all I've heard so far. What else would you want to see? There's got to be some other mods that you guys haven't seen me do yet. It's a diluted N through Lux. Yeah. A diluted one. That's
pretty much it. I don't know. You can do a proper filter on the top.
Do a proper... Why? This poor fan filter. It's nice that they include these and they're, like, they're removable, but these magnetic strips keep falling off of it.
It's not great.
I really like the, like they said, I really like the panel setup and, like, the filters. It seems way better than the Evolve.
I need a desk in front, though.
But it is definitely just a $100 case. Just like all the other ones. Yeah.
Or rather, a cheaper clips.
No, the Eclipse is cheaper. The Eclipse is, like, their cheapest case line. This is, like, a cheaper Lux.
Cheaper Pro.
Cheaper Pro. Yeah, I think the Pro is, like, $130. This is the Pro-M.
I thought the Pro-Ms were, like, $70.
The Pro-M, this was $99.99. I have it linked in the description.
Because it's tempered glass, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So I think the regular version isn't. Oh, that's right. They always have screws. I never knew why they made this hardware, like this radiator tray, and then they put screws on both sides. It's like the most... I never used the one in my Evolve. I got rid of it so fast. I mean, like I said, there's a lot of features in the Phanteks cases that I find probably really nice for just basic builders. But they're just absolutely worthless for, like, a lot of custom loop stuff. But, I mean, I plan on modding this case anyways, so we'll have fun with it. You guys want to see some kind of top rad mod? I'm kind of slightly upset with Hank that we have to keep the 5 1/4 bay, but we'll work with it. Jesus, this thing
is... Yeah, just cut it up.
Cut it up. Well, yeah, and actually we'll see how much of it we even have to use for an infinity mirror. That should be a pretty fun mod. Oh no, there's been somebody talking in Facebook. I think it's good old Sean. Where is it still screwed on?
Pretty compared to the Pro and the Lux.
Yeah, I was thinking that too.
Far lesser experience to work in.
I was thinking probably you have to go with a 280 on top or in the front as well. And maybe a 360 in the top, as long as that, like I said, we can get rid of enough of the 5 1/4 bay. Wow, this thing is... Why is it so... My ball was never like this. That's really tight. Tight like a toyga. Okay. Well, we've disassembled most of the case so far. All we can do other than that is take out this PSU shroud, but that will take a little bit more work. I think Hank should be getting in the stuff for the infinity mirror pretty soon, so we can start on that. Like I said, I'll be showing off my little LCD screen, like a modular LCD screen mod that I have in the works in this case. And a dual loop, perhaps. That would be a fun challenge. I would definitely have to say that much. because, but I do have like a set of dual res mounts from Singularity. I bet you can fit a dual res combo right here, as long as you get rid of this, all of this. But
420 mod with a shroud on top, and then a 280 in the front, dual loop.
Must use purple pastel from UFO. We can get some purple pastel from UFO. We can definitely do that. He should have some even newer stuff soon as well. Noise.
Yeah, the graphite stuff.
Yeah, the graphite stuff. And then we've also got... I've also got this new 3D mixture ready to go for the test bench, which shouldn't be too much longer. I know it's been a while since I worked on that, but I'm just waiting on Rod from BS Mods to get done with the block for the GPU, and then I'll probably just splurge and buy the rest of the parts for it, and we can get it all kind of wrapped up. Yeah, should be fun. That should, hopefully that happens before DreamHack, which is at the beginning of June. So if any of you guys are going to DreamHack, you guys will see me there. I'll be doing a build there with EK. We'll just be doing a CPU loop for one of the attendees. So if you're attending the BYOC at DreamHack, be sure to find me and you could potentially get a free CPU loop, which would be fun. I'd be happy to put a loop in somebody's case. Let's see. What else we got going on? Motherboard backplate.
Free CPU loop in the Ely changes block.
Motherboard backplates, I build one for every case I use. I like that idea. Like, do you mean more of like a motherboard tray, or what do you mean by a motherboard backplate exactly? I think I know what you're talking about, but then again, I'm not sure. You can always DM me. And you're supposed to DM me about your ball valve that you won last week, man. Like, where's the DMs? What did I ever do?
Might be saying make the motherboard tray detachable.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering. If he's talking about like a detachable motherboard tray mod, which I could definitely do. That would be fun. So,
in this case.
Yeah, we could really cut this case apart if you guys want. Like I said, I'm really appreciative of Brian from Phanteks. I don't think he's watching tonight, but I'll have to show him some of this stuff. Like the Rampage 6, maybe? Yeah, so maybe... Because I doubt this fits EATX. I'm pretty positive it doesn't. But we could make it fit EATX. We could, like,
well,
redo
Asus's EATX isn't really EATX. Like, one.
Yeah, it depends. Like, the R5E that I have, it's hardly EATX. It's, like, what is it, like, a half inch bigger? Like, not even an inch wider than an ATX case.
Yeah, it just uses the same stand mount.
Yeah, it uses the same 9 standoffs. It just extends a little bit further. But that is, I guess, the only bone to pick I ever had with the Phanteks cases that I used is the motherboard tray area. One, a lot of people try to fit those EATX boards in there and it doesn't fit. And two, I really don't like all these like drive mounts or whatever these are. I mean, like I said, it's great that they have like these easy to use features in here, like the rad tray and all that jazz, the nice PSU shroud. But a lot of it is just stuff that I don't use and I'd rather cover this up. So maybe we could work on like a custom, you know, mid panel for this whole case. Which would be fun. That'll definitely be a lot of work, and I can probably draw up a lot of it on, like, Autodesk, like I have in the past for the test bench. We can get that worked out. But, I don't know. There's probably lots of fun we can have with this case. Definitely.
I'm going to get you a Pro or a Lux. I can show you exactly what a proper Phanteks case looks like.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I like these Phanteks cases, the regular ATX size cases. Like, I think this case looks really good, like I said. But it's just you're always going to be limited. When you're working with a case this size, like I said, the Evolve's like the same size, the P300's the same size. You're always going to be limited for water cooling no matter what you do.
The layouts are the same.
Yeah, the layouts are the exact same. Like I said, the interior, like I said, looks exactly the same. The only thing that's different with the Pro M between the two is this freaking drive cage. So, I don't know. It'll be a lot of fun to work with. So, it's all steel. So, at least we can work with it. It shouldn't fall apart on us. But, once again, thank you, Phanteks. If anybody from Phanteks is watching. Yeah, Primo Relux would be fun to work with. I just didn't want to grab a massive case to work with. I don't know. The Define S was pretty big. It's definitely bigger than this. And it fits a lot more. But
kind of like the Pro where you side pans. So
we could do our little trivia question here, though. I can do that for you guys. It'll be for Halo Lux, either the digital or the regular, whatever you prefer. You'll just have to DM me if you are indeed the winner. But I'm going to mute myself in Discord so they can't cheat. So, now that we have our privacy, even though they're still watching, I will ask you guys a question. So the first person to answer this in chat, in either Facebook chat, Twitch chat, or YouTube chat, whoever answers first correctly will be the winner of, like I said, a Phanteks Halo Lux. I have them kick ass. Oh, yeah, they do kick ass. I don't have any yet. I would love to get some. But one of you guys can get one tonight to start your collection. So the question is, what is Phanteks' most expensive case? This should be pretty easy for all you Phanteks fans. Let's hear it. Any chat, let's go. There we go. Mighty voice, he's so fast. Why must you always win, mighty voice? You're taking all my money. Technically, Death Slice is right. But I'll take a lead. Carlos was just behind him.
Yes, because I typoed it twice.
You typoed it twice? You're terrible.
I typoed it twice and still got a first.
Actually, I think Twitch is the best place to watch now for the giveaways because I made the... I think because we got affiliate on Twitch, we get to have the low latency streaming. So
that always seems to be faster on YouTube.
Really? It's still fat? Were you... I thought you were on Twitch right there.
I'm watching YouTube right now, but like every single stream that I've ever watched that is dual streamed on YouTube and Twitch, it has always been faster on YouTube.
Yeah, like I said, just tonight I switched to the low latency thing. I think it just became like an option for me because I'm an affiliate now. So I don't know if it's any better or not. You guys have to tell me. But...
Well, again, on average you were like 6 seconds latency.
Yeah.
Now it's like 3 or 2.
Yeah, exactly. So, I don't know. Little improvement. Let me know what else you guys notice about the stream that needs improving. And about more mods. But... I think we've got some good ideas already. Like I said, we can probably work out something with the top. Just because actually removing just this rad tray doesn't entirely do it because there's still like the rails for it back here that really kind of stop you from mounting anything. You can also mount a rad higher without it in there. So we'll probably be modding this top up a bit. Maybe we'll just make a new top panel for it. Even though it is a pretty decent, I mean, it's really basic top panel, but combine a nice metal grill with a nice rad tray, and it's pretty decent top, to be honest. So, not bad, but we will get to some mods on it. We can do something with the front panel for an infinity mirror. Probably just something else altogether with the front panel. Like I said, make something cool to cover up the grill mesh or whatever. I think that'll be a pretty easy mod. And a new PSU shroud. Perhaps dual loops if we can convince Hank to splurge on all those kinds of parts, because that's always fun. Y'all just spam him with emails and we can probably get it done. Tell him we need this stuff. But other than that, I don't know, we can also do the tempered glass etching so I can show. I really wanted to do that. I wanted the. It was too bad that Jeremy was gone last week because I would have rather had him just do it. Oh, what is on the back? I would have rather had him do it and then send it to me, but it didn't really work out that way. So I'll have to send this piece of glass to him. And
have
then
you seen what some people have done before with tempered glass panels where they fire off sparks from my grinder at a covered up section? You know, just have a
really?
Section that's covered and a section that's not, and then you fire off the sparks and the overheating or like inclusions or something melts into the glass.
Really?
Yeah, lots of echo.
A major echo.
It's probably an echo it's an echo in Discord itself. It shouldn't be on the stream. Because I have you guys on a laptop right now.
Yeah.
No, I don't think it's echoing in the stream. Viewers, is it echoing in the stream? Let me make sure I got the chat up.
I didn't hear the echo on the stream.
Yeah, the sound is pretty bad. The echo is terrible. Yeah, there shouldn't be an echo in the stream itself. There just is in Discord because, like I said, you guys are hearing yourselves in on my mic in Discord. But I have...
Gotta mute the other stream.
Yeah, I have desktop audio actually muted for the stream, so they can't hear that. They're hearing the direct input. Actually... I wonder if they hear Discord at all. Do you?
No, they do.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. But yeah, they don't hear it directly. They only hear it through the mic. That's why it's so loud.
Yeah, no echo now. It sounds fine.
It's not an echo in Twitch, but the quality is not as it usually is. Really? That's unfortunate. Like, yeah, you're just talking about like the resolution.
It sounds kind of garbled a little bit.
Oh, like the sound quality itself is crap?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I think I know why. Nice hair. Thanks, Saint. I appreciate that. I kind of like it got all messed up earlier, but maybe I fixed it. I don't know. I don't really care.
So, has anybody used the Halos yet?
The voices saturate. Maybe it's just the levels.
On digital.
I don't know what the digital is all about. Is that just like more addressable? Or
yeah, basically.
Okay, that's all that means. I turned down the volume, but maybe that's too low. I think it's just the mic that I have is really bad quality mic, so we should probably just upgrade the mic.
Yeah, you should probably get like the UX2 or something.
Yeah, I don't know. Even like a Yeti Snowball USB mic wouldn't be that bad. This is a terrible, like this is a $10 like lapel mic that I have strung up there. So it's under the camera. Yes, upgrade. What? Okay, I'll have to write that down. And I got a Mighty Voice, you gotta PM me about your Halo. Your single Halo. What are you gonna do with one Halo, Mighty Voice?
Use it with the other two.
Oh, damn. He already has two. What?
That's a good answer.
This is the only reason why he showed up. He was just like, I need one more Halo.
But, I've missed too many streams lately.
No, Jason's in here.
Yeah.
Also, the Halo's digital available in gray, whereas the original were not. Oh, that's cool. They have gray frames now. I know that they have aluminum and plastic, and like I said, tonight we're just giving away one of the plastic frames, not the aluminum, sadly.
Damn.
Sorry. Yeah, what ones do you have right now, Voice? Do you have the plastic ones?
No, I don't have any yet.
Oh, you're already planning on buying two.
Well, I was planning on buying probably three.
Ooh, then I only have to buy two. Look at that. You're welcome.
Somebody wants the voice chat.
You should create a low-profile 120 RGB fan. How do I create a fan? I would love to.
The fam?
How do I join voice chat? You click on the voice chat channel we're on, dude, and then you can definitely join in. We would love to have
it. All on Discord.
Yep. It is all on Discord. That's correct.
So does summons back to my game.
I mean, a single Halo come with RGB setup, or you have to buy that?
Wait, what?
This I was looking at the Phanteks. Say, I only see the single Halo digital.
You can buy the cable separately.
Yeah, there's a couple different splitters and whatnot, and I forget adapters as well.
Well, I wasn't sure if you had to have something. Because my board doesn't have the RGB.
Yeah, I forget how you control them. How?
There's two different kits. There's the Luck, which is the metal one, and it comes with the cable. Or you can go to Phanteks' site and actually buy the cable for your other one.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's what I thought. We also, I think when I used them down at PPCs in one of the builds, Jeremy just like soldered them directly to another 4-pin RGB setup, so like we just repinned it out.
That works.
Yeah.
Now with the digitals, they're 3-pin EMX addressable.
Okay. Yeah, and a lot of those things should be able to plug into like your motherboard if you have a header. Yeah. What's up, Death Scythe?
Yeah, you can join in. Mark one.
I believe we'll be wrapping it up here. We'll be back, I think, Thursday night though, because. Not only do we have this case to mod, we've got my roommate's build that I've made like a new top panel for it though, and we haven't started to cut up the case yet. We haven't installed the top panel, so we got that, because we'll be putting in a loop in that very soon. So we got some mods planned for it before we get in the loop. So I think that's what we'll have on Thursday, is the beginnings of the mods for his case, for his custom loop, which should be fun. Some Dremel work, more than likely. Other shenanigans, I'm sure. Do I join the Stream Lounge voice chat? We're all in general voice chat right now, actually. Yeah, you should be able to see us. It's not a hidden channel.
It's a little quick.
Doing upgrades to the PC or getting a 3D printer at the moment.
3D printer would be nice.
Yeah, they got a couple deals going on Newegg right now.
Hmm.
I'm kind of interested. They had the Monoprice Select Mini 3D V2 for $220.
No,
like over $300.
We should. Okay, right. Yeah. So Thursday night we'll definitely be back. Should be same time, 8 p.m. I believe, unless you guys have a better time for that. Let's see, what else? Next week, like I said, we should be getting started on that loop for my roommate, so we'll be like bending tubes, installing parts, all that jazz. Definitely some more giveaways to go along with that. Don't forget the DIY tools discount. So any of the tools in the DIY tools category are 10% off with that discount code below. So definitely check that out. As some of you know, the Discord is also linked down there as well. So join up, hang out, we can all chat. Definitely a good place to stay in touch. Woot. Okay, right, thanks. What's
okay,
that?
Hello, sorry.
Mighty Voice got them tonight, the one Halo. He has to DM me. He can do it. I believe him. Oh, he already did. Look at that, on top of it. But, let's see, what did Sean say? I like how you have the other camera view in small cutout box with the main camera view. Good job, Matt, says Hank. Wow. You must still be at Hooters, still drinking, if you were saying good job. So, thanks.
Hey, place to drink.
Apparently, that's what he says. I don't know. We don't have a Hooters here. But I might go have a drink shortly. But I will see you guys again on Thursday night, 8 p.m. Maybe I'll pop in between there with some short stuff like that. I'll be putting together, I've been working on my PC the past few days, doing some maintenance. So maybe I can give you guys a clip of filling it or something like that. Because it's currently in pieces. So there's some fun to be had with that. You know, I still never got my Christmas ornament, says Mighty Voice. Well, that sucks because we're all out. Aw.
Hey, Matt, got a question.
You know what, though? There's this great thing about Christmas, and they have one every year. So, there's always next year. Take your Halo and just be happy.
Hey, Matt, got a quick question for you.
A mic suitable for your setup, yes. What's your question, sorry?
Any idea why when I run the Qfan for the Asus boards, it would keep giving different readouts every time?
Like you ran like the Qfan, like
the BIOS.
Yeah, did you do like the Qfan monitor thing or whatever that is, where it like tries to detect the lowest RPM of your fans?
Yeah, sometimes it doesn't.
Yeah, mine usually it would be, they would always be right. Like it vary maybe like a percent or two on some fans, but
probably 40-50%.
Yeah, I've never seen that. That's really weird. Are you sure that the headers are set to PWM? I know that it likes to default them to DC.
Yeah.
I've noticed that.
PWM fans are set to PWM and DC for the other.
Okay.
But it's like every other time you get weird variations. I can't figure out what the hell's going on.
Yeah. I guess what I've done is, because even when I've done the Qfan configuration thing, it still sometimes won't let me put in manually input that like lowest RPM or lowest percentage for the PWM, so I always just go by the lowest that I can put in. So, I don't know. It's sometimes kind
of
hairy.
That's sort of what I did. I just let it default.
Yeah, to the lowest it could do. That's not a bad idea.
Cancel the...
Yeah, I'm at Hoots, he said. Watching, though. Clearly, I'm glad you watched tonight. We'll have more of your mods planned for the next streams. If you have you gotten in all of the Infinity Mirror mod stuff yet? I figured we'd use cable mod LEDs for that. At least I would request we use cable mod LEDs. They should be probably the best.
The other Matt.
The other Matt.
Digital LEDs.
What does he need to do with your LEDs? What's wrong with them?
The cable mods coming out of the digital LED system.
Oh, that's right. Like, that should be fun.
Actually, I have a question. If anyone knows, are the cable mode LEDs compatible with the Phanteks LEDs?
As far as like directly with their hubs, I'm not sure. Maybe with their
plug-in? It's the same. I mean, it's the same connector, but I'm afraid to try something, you know, so I don't want to try.
Yeah, if anything, I would just, whatever connector or hub that you have, I would hit up matt@cablemod.com, just email him, and ask him if the pinout's the same, like, as...
Yeah, I'll definitely ask him.
Yeah, because I know, like I said, that when we used them down when I visited PPCs and we put some halos in a case, we didn't have cablemod LEDs in there, but we just had the regular 50-50 addressable, or not addressable, but 50-50 RGB LEDs with the 4-pin pinout. We just like reversed a couple pins and then they worked together on like the same hub. So I think it'd be doable. I'm pretty sure it'd be doable at least. So you can always go that route. It's just a little more work.
Alright, I'm not a good model. Like, I have no skill.
I really don't like repinning stuff out. Yeah, I don't like resoldering cables a lot. I mean, I can do it. It's just not my favorite thing to do.
Yeah, I can stand it.
Yeah, it's just not that fun. But we have a lot of fun case mods planned for this, and we'll definitely get back to that. And we'll see you guys on Thursday night. But I think I'll be heading out now, and I'll let you guys know about what we'll be doing probably tomorrow and Thursday. So see you all soon, and have a good one.
All right, and thank you for the invite. That's
no problem, man. Everybody else join, too. I help everybody join Discord.
Sides, I have a question for you.
So.